Look at Behemoth, which I made along with you, and which feeds on grass like an ox. That's Job 40:15. Oh, here's one more thing that's very interesting about the book of Job. If you look at the creation time frame, the ice age actually came right after the flood because it was a super cooling of the earth. And so you have a mass amounts of snow dumped on the poles, huge glaciers and everything. Well, what's interesting about Job is that it was written right after the flood, and Job has more mentions of snow and ice and sleet than any other book in the Bible. So Job very likely was aware of all this snow and ice that existed at that time and which has slowly been melting off since then. But anyway, let's look at Behemoth here. What is a behemoth? Now, in some Bibles, in the commentary section, it'll say, the footnotes, it'll say, supposed to be either the elephant or the hippopotamus. Now, we have to be very careful when somebody translates the Bible and they take a word and they don't know what it means and they impose their own bias on the word. So the translation actually has a bias. This is why it's good to read multiple translations of the Bible so that you can get a better understanding of what the text actually means. Because we don't want to impose our bias on the text. We want to let the text speak for itself and we want to take it for what it actually says. Now, the apatosaur has longer back legs, a brachiosaur has longer front legs, a cetosaur has a big seat. These are different kinds of dinosaurs. In Job 40:16, it says, what strength it has in its loins, what power in the muscles of its belly. Well, all that's saying is that it has a big belly, and elephants have a big belly, so why would we rule out an elephant in this case? Hippopotamus has a big belly too, so we can't really rule out a hippopotamus or an elephant. Brachiosaurus has a big belly, so we can't rule out a brachiosaurus either. And so does a sumo wrestler. Sumo wrestler has a big belly. This sumo wrestler has a big belly. That being the case, we can't rule them out. Now here's where it starts to get more specific. Here's more details as we look at this and try to deduce what is this animal. Job 40:17 says its tail sways like a cedar. The sinews of its thighs are close-knit. Now that right there is a cedar tree. And so it says its tail sways like that cedar tree. That means its tail's got to be pretty big. Its bones are tubes of bronze, its limbs like rods of iron. It ranks first among the works of God, yet its maker can approach it with his sword. Now, does this tail look like a tail that's swaying like a cedar tree? Maybe a cedar twig, right? Not a cedar tree. What about that one? Does that look like a cedar tree? No. Okay, now we're seeing here that a hippopotamus might not fit. An elephant might not fit. Blowing in the wind, look at those tails, those giant cedar tree tails. There they are. Now that's more like a cedar tree right there.